Welcome again on the Handpan recording studio. Today I'm here because I would like to talk about the scales and the choice of your scale. It's truly a strange argument, as we have a lot of chance, a lot of scales, a lot of opportunities, and it's not so easy to understand which is the best for us, you know. So in these last 7 years, I found a sort of way to choose the best scale. First of all, depend if you are a musician, if you already know which scale you love, you like, you want to play, what you want to express with that scale, or if you are a sort of beginner or you need some help on the scales, you know. So we can take two ways when we talk about the scales. As for sure, we can put on this side the major scales and feeling, and on this side the minor feeling, minor scales, because here we have something that is creative, really happy, that we play and we would like to dance. In the other way, we have the minor scales that are a little bit, you know, close, melancholic, just mystical, you know, something more low and deep than the major. So here we can first of all decide which is the best for us. So 50% of our choices, we can for sure feel which is the best. So if we talk about someone that already know what he wants to play, what she wants to play, the best is to talk with the maker and ask for the scale that he or she loves, you know. When we have to start and choose the right scale, for sure the best is to ask to the maker a few advices, or just to other players in the handpan community, and see what we can express with that scale, with the other one, okay? Another important point is that, you know, the instrument has usually just one scale, so that is the problem. I can call it problem, because usually we cannot do what we want, or just like on a piano, on a guitar, that we can play everything. On a handpan, if we get a D minor, we can just play something like is in D minor K, or in the mystic, if we play a mystic scale, we cannot do something happy, you know. So we can decide our scale, we can choose our scale listening to some videos and listen what we feel better than anything else, or but usually we need to play the instrument, we need to play the scale for a few months to understand if that's the scale that we love, okay? So in this video I would like to give you a different point of view, because we can for sure start with a scale that could be like the D Celtic minor or the E sub I for the major feeling, that are scales that I call neutral, okay? So if we start with a scale that is like a Arabian feeling, like the Aegis or the Pygmy scale, you know, that are complex scales that are a bit strange to start with, you know, because we spend maybe one year to understand how to touch it, But if we start with a scale that is a little bit neutral, I can say, like the D Celtic minor, the E sub I, will be easier to start to develop, to get progress on that scale, you know? Maybe in 3 months you can play good. And on another scale that could be difficult, like the E-Jazz or the Pygmy or like La Sirena that I love, it's, you know, it will take more than 1 year to understand, to feel the scale, you know? So there are scales that are better than others, but another choice that you can do is, you know, the bottom notes. In these last 2 years, maybe a little bit before, all the makers or many makers started to tune tones in the bottom shell. This for me has been truly something special, and wow, a lot of opportunities from this new layout. Because, you know, imagine a player that, imagine yourself that you have to go play for the concert on an event or somewhere with 5 instruments, so a lot of money, a lot of instruments that you have to retune one day, a lot of you know, very heavy stuff to bring with you. You have 5 scales, 5 instruments, but you can tune some bottom notes and have 5 scales, so 5 instruments, in just 2 instruments. This is a very interesting new opportunity that also helps a lot if we are starting and we have to choose our first scale. Because I could order a new handpan, for example, I would like to order a D Celtic minor. But I would love also, you know, I really don't know if I will feel completely happy with the instrument, with the D Celtic minor scale. So I say, I could have a F in the bottom, and I will have a D Celtic minor and a F major. So if I don't feel too much the Celtic feeling, I could play something very happy, creative, you know, like the F major scale. So, I decided to record this video to help to choose the scale, and we can choose, ask ourselves if we want something happy, something major, open, or on the other side something minor, more mystical, more you know, melancholic, you know. So these are the 2 ways that we can choose, okay, major, minor. Then it could be a neutral scale, because I really don't know what I want to play. So a neutral scale, like, could be the D Celtic minor, the D minor, or the E sub I, for example. It is very interesting because you can play something melodic but also percussive. If we go on something like a D major, could be a little bit less percussive, more melodic, okay? But we can also get more than 1 scale in 1 instrument. So I want to let you understand what I mean. I'm new. I really don't know what I want to play. I decided to buy a sort of minor scale. In this case, it's a Pygmy. But I never touched. I just saw a few videos. I got some advices from other players, but I really don't know if this scale is mine, if I feel very good with this scale. So why not? I could ask for some tones in the bottom and maybe have more scales. So if I don't feel super with the first one, I will have some others. And then maybe after a few months, I will feel better with all the instrument. Okay? So just to let you understand. This is a minor, could be a little bit mystic, a little bit melancholic scale, you know? okay, today I wake up, I woke up and I say, today I want to play something more happy. I would like to get some relax and play something happy, no? So I can open, in this case, on a half sharp minor pygmy, I add a D and a E, you know? So I can open the scale. Today I want to play something more happy, no? This is what I mean. The choice of the scale is truly something not easy to understand. It's not easy to choose the scale I also had, and I still have some problems when I have to choose a scale for me, because I really don't know how can I feel with La Sirena, with the Equinox, with the D minor. I really don't know, because I never played the instrument, that scale, you know? So, my advice, and this is just my opinion, is to understand what I want to express, what I want to play, what I want to tell to the others, you know? I want to tell something happy. I want to be creative, I want to let dance the people, I want something that may make me happy. I could go on a major scales, you know, major scale like D major, E major, or F major, C Golden Gate, that is a strange, because it's not so major, maybe major minor, but anyway, the feeling is also very sweet. Or I want something to find myself, you know, to play mystical, melancholic, a bit more closer in winter, in a, you know, gray day. I want to play something that is more that have to find something. So I go on a D minor, a melancholic or mystic scale, or a C sharp pygmy. So I can decide between the major and the minor. This is a 50% that you can choose, understand better what you want. Then, about the scale, my advice is to start with something neutral, that could be like a D Celtic minor, a E sub I, that are two scales that are major and minor, neutral, not so deep. For example, if you ask when someone as a beginner asked me for a E-jazz scale, Arabian scale, Saladin, I can say yes, it's a very nice one, but if you have to start, you have just one instrument, you will play only the Arabian feeling every day. Maybe after 10 days you say, hey, something neutral is better, that I can play in major and minor scale, minor feeling, you know? So, by the way, ask to the maker, ask to your friend that are players in the handpan community, and for sure you will get some very interesting advices, and consider my point of view on the bottom notes. You start with an instrument that is just like a D Celtic minor, a D minor, that is a minor scale, but if we put just a F, I will have also the F major. If I put a G, I will have the G Dorian. So, you know, I will have three opportunities. I will play today in the half major feeling. Tomorrow I want to express something that is more melancholic, because I'm sad, you know. I will play the D minor. The day after I want to dance a little bit, I will add my G Dorian to the scale. Okay, you know, so for players that already know what they want, for players, beginners, or just that really don't know which is the best scale for them, okay, consider the bottom notes. That is a very new, interesting opportunity, and let me open a lot while playing. these beautiful instruments. And I really hope that I really hope that I gave you a new point of view, a new way to choose your scale, and asking advices to others is the best way, or receive a sort of knowledge from some others to understand better what you want. And for sure, the choose of a scale should be based on your expression, so what you want to express. So choose the scale on what you want to express, you know? This is my advice, my point of view, that I really hope that you enjoy and will help you, for sure. Then we will talk, I think, again about the bottom notes and these kind of opportunities, because I would love to talk in the next videos about how to touch and play the instrument, how to start touching the instrument. Then I have some other questions from you that I will, for sure, I will talk about. But how to touch, how to play, how to approach to the instrument will be one of the next arguments, okay? And we will talk also again about the tones, scales, and bottom notes. Thank you very much for listening. Share if you want. And I really hope to be helpful with these videos. Continue to follow Blessman, because I'm trying to do my best on these beautiful sound sculptures. And keep in touch. Have a good life and good music.